This is a 10-Minute Teacher Podcast, episode 699, Creativity Now with best-selling author Sean Thompson. Welcome to the 10-Minute Teacher Podcast, hosted by author, educator, speaker, and mom, the cool cat teacher, Vicki Davis. Do you remember your first day back at school? Well, today's guest, Sean Thompson, talks about how his first day back at school inspired him to bring creativity, physical, and emotional well-being to his students. Sean is the author of Creativity is Everything. He is also an educational technology specialist at the Sacred Heart International School in Tokyo and travels extensively across Asia, presenting ways to effectively integrate technology in an educational setting. Sean is also an Apple Distinguished Educator, an International Baccalaureate Educator Network Workshop Leader, a Google Education Trainer, and a Certified Google Educator. Well, enjoy the podcast.
Hey, teachers, you can make it so much easier to post your notes to your online classroom with Wipebook. Stay tuned at the end of the show to learn how you can save big on this valuable tool. Today, we are talking to Sean Thompson, who is teaching in Tokyo, but he's also author of the best-selling book, Creativity is Everything. Now, Sean, in your role as technology integration specialist, teacher, all the different things you do, how are you teaching creativity now? And I think you have some resources that we can use in our classroom. So tell us about it.
Well, first of all, Vicki, thanks a lot for having me. Excited to be here. Longtime fan and listener, so I'm glad to be a part of an episode. Actually, it's funny that we're talking today. This is our first day back at school. Now, just to give some context, I am in Tokyo, but I work at what's known as an international school. So it's set up to cater to the needs of the sort of the expat community here in Tokyo. There's a whole bunch of them, of course, because there's a lot of us foreigners around. So it's all in English, and the curriculum is developed more towards sort of a Western model. But today is our first day back. We got all of our social distancing in order here. So it's a little bit different for us, as it is for so many people out there. When it comes to creativity has always been the thing for me, right? Something that we all talk about but nobody can pin down, which is why I wrote the book. Also, the idea for me is that I want kids to get the creativity bug, because everybody eventually at some point in time thinks, oh, I'm not a creative person, and it's just not the case. You just need to be in the environment, be given some tools and some attitudes towards that. Now, in terms of the whole remote learning thing, we did that from March of last year. So, you know, it was difficult for everyone. And as an integration specialist and a coach, it was my job to try and help people with that as well. Now, there's a lot of different things we can do there. But a couple things that I focused on, one was using data to see how students were really doing, like for check-ins and things. And the other one, of course, was, you know, how do we get kids to open up and talk? Like, it's a difficult thing to be at home, more so for some than for others. But how do we get them into these conversations, and how do we help them, you know, live through this whole thing?
I really am excited about some free resources that you've created. What are some things that educators can use now to spark creativity?
One of the things I did in terms of trying to check in on kids and help them open up and have, you know, a bit of fun, I did a couple of different things. One of them was slightly more on the creation side. It was teacher-centered. This is a simple thing. I'm sure a lot of people out there have used Kahoot in the past. It's a fun little game where you have timers and you can do it remotely. But what I decided was to sort of use that for the purpose of checking in on kids, right? Have this sort of fun little thing where we're asking questions, you know, a couple of things that are fun, and basically just common sense things. Things you should be doing to try and maintain your physical and emotional well-being during isolation. So it really helps kids put their guards down and open up these conversations. And then you're also, in these conversations, they can be learning from their peers as well, right? It's not just a teacher reading from a policy memo. It's a conversation, and they can learn from their peers as well. And from there, kids can make their own as well. That's another way of getting them involved in the creative side. But the one I think is a little bit more creative side of the students and the children that are in our care is we're a Mac school, so we use Macs. All you can do is Google Drawings as well. And it helps kids open up to have these conversations through a creative release. Now, the idea being is kids are learning how to make vector graphics. Simply put, that's just, you know, colored shapes on top of colored shapes. It's addictive. It's crazy. One of my life goals is to start a whole movement based around animation in Keynote, but I digress. So the idea being they're learning how to make these icons. And that's, I can tell you from not only my own experience, but all the children that I've seen it in my classes and in my clubs and online, they get right into it. It's a great creative release. And that's, you know, what's more stress relieving than when you're sort of, you step out of time for a second because you're so focused on what you're doing, right? You lose yourself in it. So that's a very helpful thing when you're in isolation. And then when the end, what they produce is, you know, and this is up to the teacher's discretion. It can be a still image or you can animate it. A little more difficult remote learning, of course, because it's harder to give that direct support. But they end up with like a bubble. It's a picture of a bubble and it's got little icons going around it. And it's a way for them to sort of, at a sharing session later on, you know, you can do this in a Zoom or a Google Meet. And they just go through and explain what all the icons mean. And so we're all end up talking about our work, but we're really actually talking about the days we're having in isolation. So it really, again, helps people let their guards down. And it opens up conversations that are a little more difficult to have if the teacher's saying, so Sarah, what did you do today, right? It gives that sort of that bridge to communication. And I just love the fact that I can tie it to that creativity thing, which is really what I want. I want everyone to get the creativity bug. Like I said before, if someone says I'm not creative, I just cringe. We all are. You've just forgotten it. And it's not that hard to pick it up and brush it off.
So it's unteachable, and our kid, like, I could use it in my eighth or ninth grade class. I could, like, grab it, use it, or let my kids go through it.
Absolutely. I made it, and it's free. I made it. Just use this.
Love that. Okay, so fill in the blank. This is a question I'm asking a lot of educators in this time. I hope in fall 2020 that we don't blank.
I hope we don't take our eyes off the ball. I mean, I'm talking to you from a school right now that's just opened. Not all of the international schools in Tokyo have. One of the biggest ones went with like a hybrid model. So we're here. And when I see keep your eyes on the ball, there's a few balls at play here, right? Like we got to make sure we're following all the proper protocols to protect people's health. But we also got to keep in mind that we don't know what's going to happen tomorrow, right? You get that email at midnight any day saying, guess what? Something happened. We're shutting down again. So one of my goals for right now is trying to help people prep for, you know, tomorrow. What if tomorrow we went back to remote learning, right? So we have opportunity. We're all here now. So let's get those kids trained on how to use any sort of platforms we want to use. You don't want to introduce new things from remotely, right?
We had a middle school boot camp starting our first week back and the second week. And I'm just so glad we did because we have those solid connections, solid best practices. And we've even talked to our teachers about, you know, what are the habits that you want in place wherever they are? Because we just have to be ready for anything and everything. And that's just a challenge. So it's your first day back. You've got this amazing book, Creativity Now. Is creativity something you're thinking about with your kids?
Oh, yes, absolutely. Absolutely. First and foremost is, yeah, I'm here in a classroom to help you integrate technology. So we're not going to learn how to click here, click here. We're doing something that's going to help you present or somehow enhance the learning within your curricular topics. But I'm not here to teach you. I mean, everything I do, I've got a web page for every class. My objectives are there and all the steps and all the resources and videos that can help them through it. I kept telling them like, all right, so here's what's going to happen. Here's what we're going to do today. I could go for lunch now and come back and you should all be completely immersed. And like sometimes I'll actually go and I'll sit down and say, I'm just going to have a nap here for a second, you know, just to keep the light. But that's the idea, right? Like learning is changing. You can learn anything on your own nowadays. Of course, social learning and in person is very important, right? But I want them to know like, okay, you can learn anything on your own, but you don't need Google. Like this is my website. I want you to get in a habit that, okay, I'm stuck on something. You don't just run to the teacher. You get in a habit. You got a problem. Congratulations. This is where the learning happens. You're not sure what to do. Go to the website. It's probably explained there. If it's not, person at your elbow might have an idea. And of course, I am here as an expert, but the most important thing for me is that you get creative solving problems and you take responsibility and become independent in your learning.
Oh, I'm so going to use some of those, Sean, because like I always tell my students, you can't put me in your backpack and take me to college. And I'll know I have done my job when you're 60 or 70 and you're still relevant and you're still able to use anything that's thrown at you in technology because you will have learned how to learn software, but also unleash that creativity. Like that's what gets me excited is the creativity part where they're pitching and they come up with unique, different ideas. And that's the part that gets me up every morning and makes me excited. And the point and click stuff, like, you know, it's like, you don't need me for that.
Right. And then too, like when they know they can come to you with the idea, that's also, you know what I mean? I'm with you right there. It's like, oh, so you get it now. You're coming to me with the idea because you know I'm not going to just say, oh, we're too busy for that. I'm going to listen and let you play it out.
That's awesome. Okay. So the book is Creativity is Everything. We will share in the show notes the link to this teachable unit that I'm dying to get to because I'm thinking I really, really would love to use that. So many great things. And thanks for taking time out of your first day. We do have a little bit of a time difference here, Sean, to share with everybody around the world because we've all got different circumstances, different situations. But I'll tell you, having been back in school now 3 weeks, my attendance, when kids can come to school, they're there. My kids are never missing school. They're all there. It's shocking to me. They want to learn. It's unreal. I mean, it's some of the best, fastest, most exciting moments and challenging. I think they appreciate it more. So good luck, Sean. And this is great stuff. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem at all. Just one last thing. Sorry, I don't just talk the talk. I'm nuts. I'm always sharing and making things. I got another blog post that is right full. It's a presentation I did for a group called EduTech Asia that talks about remote learning for younger learners. It's got everything in there from like how to make Bitmojis for your classroom. It's got like 8 or 10 different YouTube videos that I've put together in there. I'll share that with you as well. That's a lot of stuff. People are thinking like, well, what am I going to do? And I don't have all the answers, of course, but it covers a lot of different things that were important to us, which means it's probably important to a lot of educators. So I'll share that with you as well. Thanks again.
If you use a paper flip chart, you know that after one use, you're done. Now more than ever, especially with many of us teaching from home, we have to be more efficient. Wipebook is an excellent solution for educators, no matter where you're teaching. You have to check out Wipebook Flip Chart at wipebook.com/coolcatteacher. That's wipebook.com/coolcatteacher. These flip charts make it so easy to snap a picture and upload it to your Google Drive or Dropbox for quick sharing with your students. And they are reusable dry erase surfaces, so you can use them again and again. Features like dark, easy to see borders and the Wipebook scan app make it simple to use. So go to wipebook.com/coolcatteacher right now and receive 30% off your order. Wipebook Flipchart is a fantastic addition to your classroom teaching toolkit, especially if you're teaching from home.